Baba. Ejoko ejoko ayo kun ejoko. Iran lo eda laye ran. Oni ide o kan daka ni o so lo nko. Wa mo ko nse ba to ba.
When you come into this meeting and you are sitting down looking, there's an astounding dangerous when you are before the door of the Almighty. Enemy successfully padlock your lips. There is nowhere they can
save
you. Raise your two hands and open your mouth wide. And voice up like thunder. Lord, take evil kings out of my life this month. Be seated. I pray. Amen.
Be always okay.
Just raise your two hands. A woman told me that
okay,
she has six children. Now, they will kill them to fall in numbers. And she was
looking at him.
They did not kill them when they are very young. So they killed them after they graduate out of university. Now, they were remaining just four. And where we are praying, and I saw a hand I want to kill the remaining three out of four. And I asked mother, what about your mother? And she said she has gone. Before her death, and she told
a
member that she told her way this word, so raise your two hands so you can be able to pray. Raise your two hands, Lord. A woman told me that she would like one of her son or daughter to talk with her father from England.
Only thing about
to
hello.
She said every time I said hello,
God drew 5 minutes.
I must wait or pause for a while. Because whatever she say,
hello.
So when I say hello to him,
hello. Hello, ma. Hello, sir.
So hello, sir, or ma. And he or she will continue to bark
hello.
Like a dog. And she continue to bark like a dog.
Go there, go for 5 minutes.
And she can bark like that for good 5 minutes. And
thereafter,
he or she now say,
hello, sir.
Hello,
you are
sir.
Okay, wow.
Like thunder, I want you to voice out wherever you see it. And this is what I'm talking about. They are the ones that have evil kings on their body. A man of God, a old general overseer of a church.
Only Akinbiyi ma Oluwani king wa be. Agbara gba 65
he called my name that Akinbiyi ma the Lord said I should come and meet you an aged man.
Olomo kan lo ku fa won.
And he said he has only one child left for him.
That ti pa meta.
So enemy has successfully killed three.
Only king wa lo wo omo na nu moto.
I was so to go and look at the child right in the vehicle.
Bi mo se dudu moto mi o kokko
ri. I go there I did not see him or her.
Mo wo ka. Ese en toni king wo. Wani wa so pe ko jade la be seat. Jade.
Tell him how to wash your jade. Yoshina came out.
Omo 24 years old.
A 24 years old person.
What is so ki bi omo 3 years old.
As a made string like a little lad.
Oni e just be se bi de ni sir. Oni lara.
The father is that the way
so ki ni inch kokan.
Every year.
No way me just okay.
String.
Nigba
when I tell you that I witness you will pray. Evil king, get out of my
life. By the power. You're dead,
Jesu. Onwawa.
Amen.
Ejoko kuka, ejoko.
You can have your seat one more.
Ejoko kuka.
One more. You can have your seat.
No, it's okay.
Raise your two hands.
I didn't mind you calling only my lady. Please go by our church. Move back home. Serious, but
why you? Oh, what about you? Anytime you come to this shop, make sure you are a serious minded person.
Ma, Jake, Shubaye, Mija. Ma, Jake, Taula, Salam.
Or on Lano Mamba, or Rusato Joko.
Baye, Mija. Baba mi o ma je ko ta o lo wa sara mi
mo gbadura e o serere.
I pray you will prosper.
Okan na won loro olorile de Nigeria ti oro won ti yaro.
One of the affluent men that has the north wealth. They invite me to come to his house just the ones, not the one that was very proud. As soon as I got there, and I asked him, what exactly you want me to come and do here? And he said, I should enter that room. And I saw a young man, very handsome, and he was twisted like a snake. He now called me Woli.
Only I pray for me, Dada.
He said I should pray for him very well. He came back from the U.S. to come and do a wedding.
21 years, don't know the U.S.
And he spent 21 years in U.S. He got wedded on Saturday, and on Sunday he could not rise anymore.
Come down.
I should help him. All the mansion they bought for him is in material. And the one that took me to that place, we are crying. And I asked him to lock the door.
Baba.
Saying, Father, lift up this man. And the Lord said, I can raise him, really. If the mother could set him free. And she only had this one.
We are always okay. Wow.
Raise your two hands. I want to pray with all our
prayers.
So when you now observe the judgment, you are not
going
to undo you.
Baba, me to me na.
My Father,
me. In the name of Jesus, by the power, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, Oluwawa.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Bar Olua.
And listen to the word of the Lord. In the midst of those that surround you and as well afflicting your life. At this midnight, may your life be set free.
We are always okay, Olufa.
Raise your two hands, beloved.
All you
you will not fall over my life.
Thank you. Yes. Oluwawa.
Amen.
Now I am just okay.
Raise your two hands.
Baba.
Father.
No fear, Jere, Lagos State.
I want you to use your blood to cover a Lagos State. Use your blood to cover a Lagos State. In the month of April, swallow earthquake.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Namaskompo Shatala Bariyama. Lagos State. ati ilu kan ni northern state je ki eje jesu pa won mo
part of Crusade
ma ro bi pada iwo eje jesu ma ro bi pada
avert evil
jesu oluwa wa.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Baba,
Lord, I will thank you for the work of signs and wonders you are doing here.
And your family, to 1 million at our tomb.
Thank for the people that are present here and those on the way.
Baba,
Father, accept our thanks.
Lord,
of those
that
said amen, walk out your power.
Labi, koja.
And pass through this place.
She at your canwayan.
Open the air and the mind of the children. Glory be unto Jesus. Welcome the
presentness
to you into this prophetic prayer meeting.
1 Samuel 15. So 1 Samuel 15. 1 Samuel 15. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Samuel 15.
Verse 13.
Verse 13 to 15. Verse 13 to 15. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That was the 1 Samuel 15:13-15. Okay, hallelujah, King Bosama. Okay. Samuel said to Saul.
And Samuel came to Saul.
Saul said for pay.
And Saul said unto him, blessed be thou of the Lord. I have performed the commandment of the Lord.
Samuel, you pay.
And Samuel said, what manner then this bleating of the sheep in my ear, and the lowing of the oxen which I hear? And Saul said, they have brought them from the Amalekites. For the people spear the best of the sheep and of the oxen to sacrifice unto the Lord thy God. And the rest we have utterly destroyed.
Galatians 6. Thank you, Jesus.
I decree in the name of Jesus Christ. If you see any woman here tonight, that enemy has boasted that he or she will die with her pregnant. And those that boast against you, we die.
Galatians 6:7-8.
Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap a life everlasting. Lift up your head, the Lord asked me to talk to you.
What am I doing? Schedule 25 minutes.
I do not want to jot anything down. I want you to concentrate so you can be effective with me.
A lot of times,
stay in heaven and do things that pleases him. And he has certain attributes that no man do have. So if you want to show God unto a man, you must be someone that knows everything. And the Bible says our God is eternal, meaning that doesn't have the beginning, neither the end. And he said, he doesn't have the beginning and the end. And the Bible says our God is forever. He doesn't die. We all came to this planet. Well, one day, if Rachel did not come, we will depart one after the other. And the Bible talks about our God that has all power. And the all power belongs to God. And listen, beloved. And if one has all power and there's nothing left that he cannot do. And the Bible talks about our God that our God, as much as he has all power, and name is eternal, and he's another, as he has everything. So he has might or strength to do everything. And this is the kind of God we are serving and we are calling on him. And he can create something out of nothing. And he can bring all things and to exist as if that thing has not been created. So the power of God is so great. And to the point that if you try to describe it, you will not know the exact thing to say. And Paul talks about him, saying, how great and unsearchable power. So his way is unfathomable. So you cannot know the exact path. So whatever you know about him, that is where you know. So it's more than what you know. I would like to pray. As you say, amen. God, in a different dimension, will reveal himself to you. So this kind of God is what we are serving. Do you know if a Christian knows the kind of God he or she worship, they will not have any phobia for anything. Many times, not obtaining our prosperity, it premises on doubting the power of God. Thinking about the end of God, realize the problem. That's why the Lord spoke to me this afternoon. And the Lord stated all his attributes, and he now said, people are playing a costly game with him. So is it costly things for you to play a game with God? Let our wife play the game with her husband. Even though the husband might not know what she is doing behind him. And let the spouse play game with his wife. Because the wife did not know the exact time more than the hour she leaves. And at times, it is possible a man of God to play game with a member, asking them to go and fast, and his counsel for him to continue. Still, the church did not know. Because there is no eyes that penetrated to his wall. But the person I'm talking about, he created eyes, and he can see all things. And the God I'm trying to explain to you, he has ears. And he can hear everything. And the psalmist now says, if I move to the depth of the sea, I will find him there. If I go to the great beyond, I will find him there. If I move to the wilderness, I find him sitting in there. There's nothing his strength cannot do, and there's nowhere the eyes could not see. And there's nothing he could not see. Everything under this planet Earth are his messenger. Everything commune with him. Everything talk to him. And he now speaks to everything. Beloved, it is very awful for you to play a costly game with that kind of God. It is so awful for you to place a game on ground, asking God to stay one side and for him or her to stay on the other side. It is very awful for you to deceive that kind of God. And the one that before you see it, you know the end of the game. So it is an understanding game if you are playing such game with him. And that's why the Bible says, no one on earth can deceive him. Because he has an eye that he can see. So we cannot despise him. And like a man that is are stealing another man's tuber of yam. And he told the lad that he should look whenever he sees anybody coming, he should come to him. And immediately the lad now cried. The people are looking at us. And the man now left the place, calling that child, who is that person? And I told that lad, I ask you to watch if anybody comes around, try to alert me. And by the time he wanted to and he cried loud again, saying that people are looking at us. And this man came. So who is that person? And thereafter, I now review that the father should look up. They are looking at us.
That's okay.
And the owner of the farm could not see us. Even the farmer that is living in the surrounding did not come to the farm. But the one that created eyes can see. And the one that holds the earth and its fullness, he can see. It is an outstanding problem to play a game with God. Sit right and set your eyes on me. And many a times, when we think we are very clever with God, I'm telling you, we are a fool.
Like Paul was in Corinthians,
Paul is talking to the Corinthians, saying, we are the wise ones.
We are you not had.
And we are the learnings of this world. Can God has turned this wisdom of this world to madness? So if you not think that we are very clever with God, it's as if we are pinching our destiny with a needle of desolation. Play a costly game with God and lose a great gathering. And he lost his strength. He lost his glory. And the most terrible thing is the garment of glory placed on him, thinking that he doesn't think he's finding glory, was lost as well. And he told them, Adam and Eve, in the midst of the tree, this one, you must not eat therefrom. And Bible says, our father wants to be like God, and they play game with him. And Adam and Eve, we really want to know what God do not want them to know. And after God meets just a day fellowship with them. And Satan entered into the farm of garden, say, why are you not going to eat the fruit in the garden? And Satan now told them, the very day you eat out of this, then your eyes will be well open. Eating that fruit is not important, but our forefathers really want to be like God. And the very day you eat out of the fruit, you will be like him. And they will now realize, the very day he wants to compete himself with God, he was dropped out of the heaven. So Satan knew a greater sin. He know that pride is a great sin against God. I now said, I want you as well to play game with him. Please eat whatever I ask you not to eat and be like him. And they ate from it. At times, if you open your eyes to where God do not want you to open it, then you fall into problem. You cannot see where understanding problem lies. And they all lost everything given to them.
Adam, Genesis 3, verse 9 to 10. Adam,
and in Genesis 3, and the game started, and God called on him, Adam, where art thou? Instead of Adam to say, Father, I am here, I have eaten the food you have commanded me not to eat. And he said, Lord, I heard you, and I was scared. And God said, there's no fear in this garden ever since he created it. And that is why you see a lion walking in your kitchen. And that is why you see a wolf bringing food from the farm. And that is why you see contrives or serpents sleeping on your bed. And that is why you see the sheep and the wolf that will get together. Now tell me, where did you see the fear you are talking about? And Allah said, these people have despised him. They have played a costly game with him. And what being God Moses, who now told you that you are naked? And does it greet you like in the naked form? The glory, the garment of glory I clothed with you, where is it? And game started in the garden. And Allah came up. He said, come now. Adam, you are the first person I put this garden in charge of. So for you to till, so why now are naked? Adam started playing game with God. Instead of Adam to tell God, I was naked because I had the fruit and I said, Lord, a woman you gave me, though I did not ask for her. And a woman you made my companion that did not make any request of her. And she was the one who gave me out of the fruit. And the Lord said, you woman, why have thou done such thing? And she said again, you are the one who created that serpent. We did not call on him. And she eat that snake responsible for the fruit we are eating. So nobody will seek anything from heaven except he or she tender a request. So I have learned from this. So no man on earth will lay hands on Lord except they tender their request. I have learned from this. Now, before any man we obtain a good wife, he must first set his eyes on my favor. And for you to obtain my eyes of favor is not easy at all. I will never give a man a wife except he go into prayer. I have learned from this event. So you are playing game with me in this matter. So your game you are playing with me, you cannot win the game because before you arrive, I kiss someone because right from the inception of the world, I know that you will fall. And I have my a close substitute. And nothing will just catch heaven suddenly. I saw some people in a certain area that will not believe
anybody
till he or she
died.
And the very day God makes use of you, and he places somebody beside you, which is your close substitute, he will not allow you to see him. So if you not do good before him, he can drive that substitute to go to another town. But believe me, to every man, God has a close substitute. I believe him to that time. So if you're a man of God and you see that kind of things, they do not believe to that point, they will fix an alternative beside you. Because you are a human being. Beloved. The game we are playing with God is what caused our life to be in this state. Is anybody ready here tonight to tell God, Lord, let us take the game out of the matter and let us discuss on crucial matter? God is ready to deep his hand in your matter. And listen to this. Many Christians are suffering now greatly because they are playing games with God. And Apostle Paul warned Galatians, that God is more than something you can deceive. It's more than God you can despise. It's more than God you can play a costly game with. Whatever you sow is exactly what you are going to reap. If you sow into flesh, do not think that God will bless you spiritually. So whatever you plant, you're going to harvest at the head. Things will refer to as mercy. If you do not follow God orderly, you may not obtain it. Do not allow anybody to deceive you. Tonight, we don't need to go into prayer. We need to dialogue with God and take the game away from Him. Here lies an outstanding matter. Let me try to tell you the secret. You are playing game with God when you are making jest of the word of God. It is you are going to suffer for it at the end. Many ministers of God do not have the food to the church members because of the money they will take from them and they will eventually lavish it. And listen to the truth, beloved. When you are ready to be loyal with God, and God is ever ready to be loyal with you as well. Here lies an understanding matter. And there is a certain portion of the Bible that I love. And there is a prophet in the Bible called
Jeroboam.
And this prophet told Jeroboam, Solomon had failed and the kingdom has been torn in his hand. Now listen, so later you now be a king in the land. And really, Jeroboam became the king of the land. What surprised me in this? And when Jeroboam enthroned, he was playing game with God. He placed an idol in Dan and Bethel that people should not go to Jerusalem anymore. Believing God, and he doesn't believe God, that God is the one that gave him the kingdom. By the time the kingdom is having problem, Jeroboam now called or invited his wife. And a prophet that told us this is a holy God and he hates unrighteousness. And I want you to disguise yourself and go and meet that man. So go and tell him that our child fell sick. So don't let him realize you are my wife. Well, the moment he knows this, it's going to be a problem. And the woman really went to him. And God now told the prophet. And the moment the wife stepped into the prophet's apartment, and prophet now told her, please don't trouble yourself. You are a wife of Jeroboam. Step in. You have disguised yourself. Now come and listen to heavy mercy God had for you. So God cannot be deceived. You cannot play game with him. In you, you are going to eventually lose. There's nothing concerning God about this. Beloved, listen to this truth. You are playing game. When you know that you are black in compression and you turn yourself to be in white, God knows the kind of paint he used to paint you when he formed you. So write it down, you eventually back into your normal color. And that giving color will eventually spoil. So you are playing game with God, beloved. When the man you couple yourself with is not your husband, you are a second wife in that house, I'm telling you, you are playing game. So God knows the exact person between you that holds the husband. And people now are said unto Abraham, Agar, the wife of Abraham, and by then God will refer to them, he said, Agar, a servant of Sarah.
Oh, the Abraham.
You cannot see where Bible quoted it, Agar, the wife of Abraham.
Sarah.
But they refer to as a servant or maid of Sarah. So God knew the husband, the wife, and the maid. Please, you are playing game with God. If you say your wife is not good anymore and you want to get married to another one to fill the gap, keep vacuum in your heart. I've never seen a man couple inside with three wives and get rest. On his own, lack of rest, I just sit down and you invited him to come and enter into your house. And like a youth, you are playing game with God. If you are taking Indian him, whose head is going to be abnormal? And the brother and youth down here, they open their lips and pour in our saliva. And I declare unto them that the drug should get out of them. They do not take drug anymore. But the life is not good. But their veins and sinew have lost their strength. And they are pouring out saliva all over places. So you are playing game with God. Say you want to use alcoholic drink to rub off your thinking. You wake up and find yourself in it. So you are playing a good game with God. Many of you don't understand this. You are playing game with God. When your man rent a room for you outside, say you cannot enter out because you are going to enjoy yourself outside here. Many children of God ate to hear the truth. Whatever you saw is exactly what you are going to read. Many of you are playing a costly game with God. You will see that you are playing a costly game with God when you fail to pay your tithe. No, you can keep nothing.
No problem.
God asks you to pay 10% and you say you want to pay 7%.
No problem.
You don't even pay anything. There's no problem. So I'm telling you that you are playing game. So you should not allow any prophet in secular world to deceive you. Without holiness in and out, you will pray till you die.
John 9:31.
Have you ever heard where God answered the prayer of the sinners? You should not be deceived, the Lord. Many a time the goodness or prosperity you receive from prophet, no, that prophet received it from the angel of darkness. And there's no good miracle without attaching it to holiness. They are all strategy. Where fire is burning and you see fornication still running in that place, that is not the presence of God in place. That pastor is playing God and you know the exact time he will leave. And that game will soon come to her name. It will not last. You are playing game, pastor, if you are spending God's money. Believe me, you do not want to open more pages to the point where you are. And some people travel here and there to make sure they pay tithe in the church or to something, and you convert it to your home. I'm telling you, there's no song you render that will not make your children not to suffer.
Faithfulness leads to fruitfulness.
So if you are not faithful with God, you will not be established. And that is why these are the fathers moving up to the mountain top, and today they cannot hear someone that have headache. And they normally deceive you and they will shake before you after they marry six wives. They are playing their games to the hand.
Ọrun ti pari ayo.
And heaven has concluded and won over the game. And listen, beloved. All form of lies, they are real lies. You are playing game. You are playing game with God when you are measuring a cloth in the back market without a good measurement. You are playing game with God when you are reading some part that do not exist in the vehicle and ask them to go and buy it. All our traders. All quotation you quoted for you to get money, you get money and you spend it on sickness. And no one can ever despise God. There is no one that can do it. That is why many of us cannot sleep in our house because certain money is used to erect it. And ever since then, you open that room, you see cobwebs, and you don't know the exact thing that caught the cobwebs.
You continue to say,
oh, you demon, be back. No, not a demon. The money you use to erect this, go and remove it. Because you never gain peace of mind. Please stop playing game with heaven. Don't deceive yourself. And there's nothing we can do against this truth. If you beat it, if you kill it, if you shot at it, it will later rise. If you cut it to half saw, that saw will eventually
heal.
If you calm that saw, it will rise another place. So you are playing game with God. All kind of copulation or connection.
Outside marriage.
Extramarital affair. It will cause you to pay price. You are playing game and you will later come and suffer for it. And the Bible says, who is that man that will carry fire in his heart that will not burn him? Every man that loveth a strange woman will later be a man with one muzzle. I do pity you women when you are praying for your husband carrying concubines. Saying, the Lord, don't let him have vengeance.
Are you
telling me that your husband should not encounter problem when he pregnates a child from secondary school? You are saying that your husband should not encounter problem. And when he took another woman into hotel, he realized and understand the problem, beloved. I've never seen a brother in a neighborhood doing a form of adultery. Today, they were all begging. I met one of them in a service here. And he said to me, Aki, please get me something. I'm going back home. I told him, and I said, you are basically here on a new vehicle trying to make Mary go round. And listen, beloved. And the game was over.
Bye.
Now, the afternoon has gone tonight. And listen, beloved. And whatever is so, those people you see siphoning our money in this nation, see, give them a certain year, you will see them, they will become
mean.
And there's nothing they saw that without having an harvest. And David playing game with God. And he went to copulate with Bathsheba. And he impregnated her and killed her husband. And the way you are looking at it,
2 Samuel 11 and 2 Samuel 12 is 1 year interval.
2 Samuel 11 and 12, they have a year interval. So David covered the event, and people say, King has trampled over the matter. And the letter Job now sent to David, saying, sir, they have overcame us in the war front.
Only people,
General,
And now
he came in and was so frowned, saying, today all general will be sad.
Only one of the joker is saying, riot is good.
And you too, then that the joker saying, riot
is
standard.
I was talking with Ogun.
And the moment he told the news to David, and David asked him, don't you study the war book?
Can't
you read this word that the woman threw stone to him?
You
stay behind the friends that are playing, I really understood. So go back and tell Joab. Say they should prepare themselves more. And if that's that person, so they should continue warring on. And they should not forget. And the sword moved to the left and right. And after that, so God now told him, you are the one that said it through your lips. Today, the sword coming against you. Today, the game has ended. A battle will be rise up against you in your household. Sword will never depart from your house. When things do happen to a man, I do not strictly come into judgment. And I will not quickly show my mercy. Because I really understood this message, it may be the things he or she saw is what he or she reads. Please, I beseech you to play a game. Because the game will eventually fall on you. So what concerns God if a man contracted HIV? A student from Ede Poly came to my office and removed a trousers and asked him what I
mean.
And he said his manhood is not working. And I told him,
only in campus, I need a campus.
Either in campus or outside campus. I looked at him.
Campus.
Say in campus. And he said, sir. So much. And I told him as well, what you want me to do? You cannot do anything. And he collapsed on the ground. So the game was over. And I told him, I have a revival in the evening. So put on your trousers. He asked me not to leave it. Please, put on your trousers. The next thing I want to come. Don't let me deceive you. The very day his eyes was opened. Realize the problem. The very day you are thinking you are more clever than heaven. It's as if you are undoing yourself. Many of you are troubling yourself. All our sister this day, you know. And a sister came to me, she had done it to the hand. And she had done a fornication to the point that the womb has torn. And she had getting to the end.
Oh, Shani Kenny.
You do not endure anyone.
And this is a pastor and you my dear.
Not your pastor will go through pain. Many children of God, they have caused you to be wrecked. Who now suffer for you with you? You are playing your game to a certain point. And you see the hand of your life.
As I saw,
Saul was told when you get to the
oh, land,
you shall kill everything. You must not spear any. If you see any pregnant woman trying to give birth, kill her and the baby. For God told Moses to write in the book of remembrance, I will destroy the Amalekite generation. Saul was given the assignment. Instead of Saul to kill all the things in the land and that started playing game with God. Thinking that God is not so wise. Thinking that God is not having knowledge, that God is not seeing
you.
And Samuel came to meet Saul. Before Saul, Son, I came and I told him all the words I've been told by God. I have carried them out. And Samuel now said, I will destroy everything. And he said, he has done it.
So
before he want to make U-turn, and there's bleating of the sheep. And the one in the
body,
and Samuel now said, the one that has behind your compound, where did you have it? And the sheep and the oxen say they can tell
us.
We cannot lie, we are
big.
We cannot despise our Creator. We seated down here. And Samuel looked at him and he shook his head. And today you have rejected the instruction of the Lord. And today God has rejected you to be his king. You will not be able to proceed in this place because you have despised
him.
And you have given a second chance to plant spiritually, and you plant and you reap corruption. And children of God that are present here tonight, I want you to quit concerning this game. God will not give you your husband with the concubine you are keeping. And God will not give you the expected mother when you are going through fornication. Kneeling down before me 10 times, touching the hem of my garment to rub your belly, I'm telling you all you've been in vain. God will not give you money when you fail to pay your tithe and offering. God will not love you when you hate your brothers. And listen, God will come back behind you when you are trained with the work of God and you are making your food out of it. And very soon, that game will come to an end. Listen, God will hate you if you hate your husband. He lies the problem. That game will soon be over. If you are stealing in your company. Because you know, I step in anything, God himself will destroy such business. And things will happen at this center. And many affluent ones in the church will not get to paradise. Realize the problem. This game you are playing with God is enough. So come and plant in a spirit realm. Let everyone converse with God. This is exactly what I'm doing. I do not want to do that anymore. If you are coming from the church and do such things, when you get down here, we do not do such.
Prayer,
without holiness, will not go beyond this room. Believe me, it's as if you are wasting much of your time. God will come against you if you cannot make use of your tongue very well. And God will be more angry against the servant of God if you are taking advantage of your members, and you are taking or extorting the money from them. God will turn against your children if you are copulating with your sheep and the husband is in the church and they pay more respect to you. And at the end of the day, you will reap something terrible. And we that are praying here tonight, our sin is a little. What our father has sowed, what we are reaping, we could not learn from our fathers. We also, we are planting a bad fruit for the coming generations. Whosoever you deceive with a fake vision and fake dream, you will pay.
Oui.
And whosoever you deceive through the name of the Lord, they will deceive your children as well. Jacob really wants to be
deliver.
And they brought Elijah to him, and God said, "There's nothing you can do.
Whatever
you
saw is what you eat."
Why are these children deceiving me? You also deceive your father.
Game to play.
The game you play with me.
So
exactly they play with you. And I said, Lord,
why now?
Kilo
day. That
I've been enslaved in this place, and the way you did, so I did with you as well. Realize the problem. The way the more game you play with God is enough. The Bible says, if sin is in my heart, God will not give answer to my prayers. They are all lies.
What is your makeup?
No matter how make up you are, if your heart is not right with God, what's your parry?
What you call play?
No matter how much you can pray. No matter the kind of gift heaven endow you, if you are playing game with God, you kill yourself. Pastors, where are the prophets that had revival and the Red Cross? Where are they? Where are the fire that burned that day? All priests. What about the revival head attacking at the clear area? Where are they? And the Adamasiba Stadium now is made for revival grand before. But where are the results of the revival? Some father died and their congregation died alongside with them. Because it was form of fashion with this.
I
want brethren to pray before you take your leave here tonight. Amazing how you pastors, whosoever that had bold you to the work of the Lord, if it is remaining a minute to go, the secret will expose. And God will lay hands on someone and begin to expose the secret. And the thing to begin to be opened.
And
there's no secret that will lead to heaven. And without being opened, or something covered without being exposed. I want to depart from telling lies,
do
deceit, hatred, and keeping malice. The attitude of godly characters, you will not be able to do. Actually, open your Bible to the book. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things that have good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. Anything that are truth, anything that are honest, anything that are just, whatsoever things that are pure, whatsoever things that are lovely, whatever things that have good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on this. You are you Christ's members? Think of this. Bow down your head for prayer.
You will learn it if I don't play game with God.
It is an understanding danger when you are playing game with God. Bow down your head, beloved.
I
beseech you, ever since the day you come to this church and you are playing game with me, I ask you to step forward and remain in their position. Come forward. If you know you are playing game with God, step out. You know you are deceiving God and as well deceiving yourself.
So don't deceive yourself
and start saying you do not receive any good things in this church. You are just deceiving yourself.
Everything you think before God,
you are pinching your destiny with a needle of desolation. God is more than what a priest, a pastor, a bishop can deceive. Are you not the one in the midst of the gathering? You are the one. When it remains you. Tell me all the things you are doing behind your wall. Is that the thing that you can complain or tell the church of God? Is that the things you are doing? Can it be a good report? Is that good thing that are loyal? Is that things that are honest? Is that things that you are doing? Are they pure? And all the things you are doing,
you are doing, and you think what you are doing, and your mind is telling you, it means you want to suffer in double ways.
Is that things you are doing? Can it be exposed? Are you still parading? Committed abortion this year. And you are still a spinster saying or complaining that your husband did not receive it. Are you here, beloved? Bow down your head and begin to converse yourself. Are you here? God just catch up with you as I'm talking. That you will be rapturable. Things you are pursuing is not a thing God is asking for.
Crying
or clamor for money, we can't stand for it. And they will give it to you, and you're not able to grab it. And then begin to spend it. I want you to observe yourself.
Is your
man that will stay with you? Is he your true husband? And you know for sure he has
a lot of
weeping.
Are you here, beloved? You and your husband, you cannot share same bed, you will be quite brief. Because there is an hidden secret you are yet to leak out.
And that secret you see is a few tasks in your hand.
Ah, dear,
it will bind you.
Oh, nile fo.
You will not be able to be rapturable. And let me pray for you outside.
But boy, was Simon proof.
And listen, who's ever put on Simon proof tonight? Every form of cheating. You planted a bitter.
Ibi ni wahala wa.
A bitter thing.
Omo koko in like ma waste owo oko.
And I know many of you like to waste much of your transport fee.
Omo in like ma waste akoko ara yin.
You like to waste much of your time.
Ba olufe.
Listen, beloved.
Oh, je ma tan re.
Better don't deceive yourself.
O le tan Olorun.
You cannot deceive God.
Olorun ko lo ngbele ara e lo ngbele. Nigba to ba ba go ara e je to ba ba yi ara e je ko se nto kan.
You did not damage God, you did damage yourself.
Osinto se olufe.
Nothing you do.
To kan Olorun.
That concerns God.
Igbeyin aye mi ma je ko da bi ti so. Igbeyin aye mi ma je ko da bi ti so. O ti n bo Olorun soro telekele o da boku soro. O ti n bo Olorun soro kelekele o da koku soro. Igbeyin aye mi ma je ko da bi ti so oba e tori ba ni te wa ke je wo ese
ba dan ye
so fun olorun pe oni ba tayo mo.
And tell God you have quit that game you are playing with him.
O je sure e olufe.
I want you and be one.
Ki o ta ma ba ba ye je fun ara.
The enemy should not spoil your life.
Ni opo igba me won ma ni ka wa Bible study ka wa Sunday school. E ro pe ntan Olorun o tan Olorun are lo ntan.
And when they ask you to come to Bible study.
Oro nti oro Olorun wa fun lati tun aye e se tun aye ero.
You will not come thinking that you want to deceive God. No.
Jesus. Oluwa wa.
Amen.
Ke ri dariji gba.
May you be pardoned.
Ke ra anu gba.
May you obtain mercy.
As you are
going to the month of April.
On Wednesday stroke Thursday.
On Wednesday stroke Thursday. I commit you into the power of Jesus. I commit you into the power of God. Evil event will not prevail over you.
Agenda
if you see any contrary agenda behind
you.
In the month of April.
Oh yeah, chuka!
May these agenda be scattered.